Thank you for listening to the 107 Show. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at 107. Email us at 107show@gmail.com. Keep the conversation going in the 107 Facebook group. Listen to us daily at 7 p.m. on newtwistradio.com. Download the New Twist Radio app from the Google Play Store.
I'm a movement by myself, but I'm a force when we're together. Mommy, I'm good all by myself.
I'm good.
But baby, you make me better.
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 And we're back here on the 107 Show on NewTwistRadio.com and the New Twist Radio app. Make sure you follow New Twist Radio on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at New Twist Radio. And follow the 107 Show at 107 Show on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter as well. I am here with Tara, Tyra, and Goose. Let me turn your mics up. Sorry.
What's up?
We are the crew that puts together the 107 Show. Shout out to everybody in the Facebook group. You know, we love what y'all doing, and you know, y'all keep us going, and we going to try to keep it going for y'all as long as y'all keep it going for us. But anyway, make sure you check out all new episodes of 107 every Monday on NewTwistRadio.com at 7 p.m. And we're going to get...
You know what I'm talking about, the iHeartRadio and all that?
Oh, thanks for reminding me. Nice. So, right now, as it stands... I'm looking at myself in my life. Right now, as it stands, you can listen to the 107 Show on demand on iHeartRadio, on Apple Podcasts, on Spotify, on Deezer, on Podcast Addict, on... There's a few more. Still
Spreaker.
Waiting for Google.
Did you say Spreaker?
Spreaker. Mm-hmm. Spreaker. Still waiting for a few more, or still waiting for Google Podcasts to accept us. But until then, pretty much wherever podcasts are being played, you can catch the 107 Show. Just look up 107, and if you can't find it, then contact me and I'll just send you a link.
Sounds good.
So contact you where?
Contact me at Jay Watson Radio Man on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. And that's about it.
Okay.
Not on Facebook though, because that's not what my name is on Facebook. But
well, you know what? You could just hit the group. Say.
Yeah, just hit the group.
Yeah,
hit the group. 107
group.
And then somebody request the group 107.
Answer the questions.
Yep. Answer the questions. I mean, it's just a couple of
they're
hoops.
Like meatball questions.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Don't stress. Don't buy questions. Just answer the damn questions.
Yeah. So
and, you get all the info you need in the group.
Tara has the what we'll be talking about today.
So we're talking about a couple things today. I did some research.
Okay.
Sent some topics to Tara. Produced. So it's a couple things that we wanted to pull out. And to be fair, to include everybody, we're looking at deep conversation topics for dating couples, as well as deep conversation topics for married couples.
Ooh.
So let's start with the dating people.
Can I stop you?
Okay, sure. Why not?
Because deep conversation.
Don't like deep conversation questions.
You just made me think of something.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Lord.
Deep conversation. Okay. Last night.
Mm-hmm.
What yes. I do?
Oh, last Lord.
Night. Oh, my God.
I'm curled up. I'm curled up in the bed ready to fall asleep. I'm dozing.
Mm-hmm.
I got my back turned to my wife. I'm looking the opposite way. I turned the lights off, but I turned hers on because she wanted the light on. So I turned all the lights off mm-hmm. except for her. I'm dozing off. She turns around and says, "Bae, when did you know you can tell me your biggest fears?
Oh.
When did you know you could be
vulnerable with me. I didn't know.
How does that pop into your head? Where did that come from?
I was watching a video
on her phone.
Okay. I posted it on my personal Facebook page because, you know, I have some views that I don't want to seem like I'm impressing upon people in the group. So mm-hmm. certain things I post on my Facebook page. So they were talking about how do you like know that a man really loves you and what things that a woman can do to like hurt a man.
Mm-hmm.
So like if a man is being vulnerable with you mm-hmm. and he's exposing like his fears to you
mm-hmm.
and you kind of like scoff at him and be like, oh, that's you being a punk, blah, blah, blah. Like he won't trust you anymore.
Well, that makes perfect sense. It's like you're making fun.
So I didn't know he was sleep. I mean, he'll turn around. He plays possum all the time.
Mm.
So, and
no,
I asked him,
no,
yes,
no.
You do play possum.
No, no.
And I asked him the questions and he, what? I don't know. Then he going to give some random date. August 9th, 2013.
You don't even remember the date.
I don't remember the date.
August 3rd, 2012.
I was like,
wait,
okay.
you were really sincere with that date?
No, he was not sincere. Because I asked him, I said, well, what specifically
happened?
What's
the significance of that date?
He would say, I don't know.
I couldn't remember.
So what happened August 3rd, 2012?
But, so did you, maybe he just said that because he knew it was a warm month.
It was a warm month. It was 10 days before my best friend's birthday.
Okay, so we're narrowing it down here. He just picked a date because he knew it was a warm month. And he knew that there was a correlation.
Uh-uh.
I'm on your side, bro.
Don't be on his side. He was just trying to shut me up. Because I'm like, if it was so significant to you that you remembered the date, how come you didn't remember what you said?
Don't remember.
Exactly. So it wasn't that significant. You was making up something so you could go back to sleep.
You know what? That's an excellent question. Babe, how do you?
Don't answer. I don't fucking know.
What's the time on that?
I can't. Seriously? You really don't?
No.
Speaking to the mic, when did you realize? Is your finger on the button? Your finger needs to be on the button.
The microphone.
So when did you realize, you know, that you could be vulnerable? Like, is that one of the things that where it made you feel like, I think I'm going to marry her because you could be vulnerable with her and expose like your shortcomings?
This kid is sending me TikToks. Do I not look busy to you anymore?
Back in 2012?
Are you saying is that when I?
That's what I asked you, and you said August 3rd, 2012.
You said no. What you just said was something about that's when guys know they want to. I didn't catch.
I said is that when that a guy knows that he want to marry a woman when he realizes that he can be vulnerable with her?
No.
Okay. Goose.
Yeah. I don't know.
He doesn't know.
Talking to the mic.
I don't know.
Again, he just is it the 800 that's keeping you from not knowing, or you genuinely do not remember?
No, it's not the 18.
What did I say? The 900?
800.
I sound like somebody's mom, don't I?
All right, well, let's get.
I don't want none of that McDonald's.
No, but
so
I don't know because I mean
there
was no event. You know, when you're in a relationship and you're building and you're steady building. You know, as you build, you become more vulnerable.
You don't have to become vulnerable. No, I mean, like, there's certain parts of you that you don't have to expose.
No, you don't have to.
But how can you not?
But this is the thing. When you're with somebody and you're really feeling that person, right?
Mm-hmm.
Things just come out.
That's true. But people are good at holding things back.
And you don't have that natural defense up.
Okay.
You just talk. And whatever comes out, you know, some things, you're like, I might be going through a little bit. But for the most part, you know, eventually you'll get to where you can just say whatever.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And then once you get to the point in the relationship where your significant other comes in the bathroom while you're taking the dump, it's like, it's whatever.
Oh my God.
Babe, do you come in the bathroom while I'm taking a dump?
I try not to.
No, hell no.
Why?
Because he doesn't have a gas mask.
I might need your help.
Oh my God.
I need my help.
That's like when I was pregnant. Okay, maybe exactly. This is an overshare. When I was pregnant, you know, I don't even care. When I was pregnant, there was a point in time because I was on bed rest. I was so constipated.
That's a pregnancy thing that happened to me too.
I was like, I need you, like, I swear to Christ, we need a reality show. I was like, get a spoon. I need you to go out there. Get
look
it
at
out.
Face.
Look at just
babe, it happens during pregnancy.
Wait.
You get constipated.
I'm telling you, it was bad. I was like, I don't care. Put your hand in there. Get it out. I need it was bad. Justin, I'm telling you.
You said nothing.
You'll see. You'll see.
I hope not.
It was bad.
You can't get. I
think that was probably the most vulnerable I had ever been with another human being.
No, because a lot of stuff that helps you with constipation can cause your uterus to contract, so you can't take any of that. Mm-hmm. So I was on my prune juice and walk, and I would make her
walk
with me because I'm like, listen, if I don't go to this bathroom, something about to happen in here.
Did you have to get somebody to go in there and take it out?
Not take it out, but like rub my back, help me relax to kind of like get it out.
It's terrible. It's horrible.
So now we're getting to the nitty gritty. So this
we need to say that for the marriage.
If you're
partner.
Not willing to cut my back while I'm on the toilet, then you ain't it.
Mm-hmm. So I mean, this what I wanted to start with was the.
I didn't smell what you.
Oh Lord, just... that is for
all right, let's go to the
different
top.
Ship.
I didn't smell what you capable.
Deep conversation topics for dating couples. Now I'm gonna say this again because I'm so far removed from dating. A lot of these that I saw on this list, I don't really know. My bad. Okay, here's one. What values are important in your life? Were they imparted to you by your parents? If not, where did they come from?
And this is for dating couples.
This is for dating.
For dating couples. So,
that's what I'm saying. I'm so far removed from that.
So if I can try to retro my mind to the dating time. Like
I know you guys are like
religion. You was dating not that long ago.
He was dating a little more than 2 years ago. Yeah, he was dating. Yeah, so yeah. It's not, you know, so I got to retro it out a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
What values?
What values are important to you?
That's a tough question, only because what values are important to me in the mate or what values are important
right.
to me?
Right. Like if you're dating someone and you're not, and it's, you know, you're really into them and it's it looks like it may be going somewhere.
So what values do I look at in them?
In them, yeah. Right. Like what is in you that you would want to see in a mate?
Well, okay, so here's one that's I'm not gonna say it's weird, but of course, you know, she had a child previous to us being together, and the way she treated that child was kind of an important thing to me.
Mm-hmm.
Not because, you know, that was my child or anything, but it was just to see what type of mother she is.
Right.
I guess in a sense that was important to me. How she could interact with my friends
mm-hmm.
was important to me. Being an only child,
mm-hmm.
a lot of my friends, y'all just met a friend of mine
mm-hmm.
that I knew, we've known each other since knee high to a grasshopper.
Mm-hmm.
How she can interact with my friends was a big deal to me.
Mm-hmm.
How she can interact with my family was a big deal to me.
Mm-hmm.
Outside of that, no, because you're learning how to catch. So.
And that is very
yeah, from
important.
Somebody who played baseball in college.
Well, you're learning from one of the best.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I can't catch a darn thing.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I can catch a cold.
And now I can't. Right. I throw something at him, he always catches mm-hmm. it. Even if I'm meaning to like hit him in the head, he catches it.
Mm-hmm.
Don't forget this is being recorded. but yeah, those are
subpoenaed in the future.
Just right. A sock. I'll toss a pair of socks at him, mm-hmm. you know.
Right.
And yeah, he'll catch
a pair of socks with feet in them.
Catching that kick.
I don't know. Catch like,
those were some of the things that were important to me.
Right.
I guess, you know, just trying to think back to it. Like, I guess more so my friends and my family
mm-hmm.
because I didn't have a child. So seeing her interact with the child
mm-hmm.
became important, but it wasn't one of the things that was like, you know, right. How does she.
I guess that is different too because, like, you know, neither one of us had kids when we got together, but I never thought about what kind of father he would be. I mean, I assumed he would be a great father because he was so great with our nephew and his sister and his mother. I was like, yo, this dude is all that. You know what I mean? Like, I knew he would make a decent husband, and so that would be like the next natural step to be a decent father.
That was important for me too while we were dating to see how he interacted with my, you know, with my daughter.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that I found, what?
I just think about one time where you were taken back by something I did.
Oh.
One time. I'll bring it up. I'll okay. let you finish.
But one thing what I thought was like very attractive was, you know, when we got really serious, you know, and we were talking about moving in with each other, and he mentioned, it wasn't even me, and I feel kind of bad about this, but he mentioned, he was like, well, you know, if your daughter's not going to be comfortable with it, then I'm not going to move in. Like, mm-hmm. he was more concerned about how she would feel
mm-hmm.
than how I would feel.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean,
I worry about you.
But I was just clearly. Like, damn, like, it's a lot of dudes that, you know what I mean, that wouldn't really care about wouldn't that. Like, that I love you.
Right.
Wouldn't be that considerate. Mm-hmm. I just want us to be together. She just going to have to get used to it. Mm-hmm. He was never like that. Like, he mm-hmm. always considered her feelings. Like, mm-hmm. he always considered her. Like, right. we always, and she gave him the business in the beginning.
Really?
Whoa, yeah. Christian. Yeah. She gave him the business in the
wow.
beginning.
Wow, but she knew him, though, even before you guys
she
dated,
knew
right?
him, but... It's different really when you know him yeah. and,
she
and you fit
him
to come
downstairs.
In here. Right. She was him downstairs.
She, wow. She tossed my stuff out the bedroom one time.
Yep.
Did she?
She took his book bag,
she took
right?
my book bag. She said, get this out of here. Threw aww. It in the hallway.
Oh. Did she tell you need to sleep in the oven or something like that?
Oh, yeah. I got that conversation on. I got that conversation recorded.
Really?
That yeah. is hilarious.
She told yeah. me
sleep in the oven. Oven.
Now
she love him.
Now, please. That's her bestie. That is her bestie. But it was a big adjustment for her, you know, and I was very impressed at how considerate he was of her feelings. Mm-hmm. Like, even though he loved me and he wanted to be with me, mm-hmm. he knew, you know what I mean, that she was part of the package, and he wanted to make sure that she was comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought that was really cool.
It made me sound like I'm so considerate.
Oh, it's the mailman. Mess up boy, my... he's about to catch it.
Who that on the porch?
Mess up my reputation out in these streets.
Right. And another...
We don't want that.
And another thing that was important to me was, and I guess Goose can attest to this, in my previous relationship, like, we have a big family, and like our
do
family,
we? I couldn't tell.
Yeah, like we go out, we have big family functions, and so I was like very,
for no reason,
very family oriented. And mm-hmm. the last person I dated was not really family oriented.
Was he from a big family?
Long story.
Okay,
but
that's for off air,
right? But Justin was very family oriented, mm-hmm. and that was a big piece for me, because mm-hmm. you know, we go on big family vacations, like yeah. we are, you know, Christmas is our thing. We right. Christmas with the cranks,
yeah.
And you gotta be ready to go.
See now, and we put it out. I just put it out there for it. Like, I have one side of the family mm-hmm. that is tight knit to the extended side,
right?
To the extended. Now I have my other side of the family that is not as tight knit. To the extended side,
okay,
but working on it,
right?
So it's kind of like, on one side I have the experience of always being around family,
right,
for different functions, and so I guess if you're used to that and being around extended family, it's kind of that. Now with y'all, so I think my first experience with a lot of family with y'all was Sights and Sounds. Easter. It was an Easter or Christmas?
It wasn't Sights. It was those plays we go to in Jersey.
Oh, at the Foundation of Life Church.
Those things.
Yeah.
That, I think that was my very first one.
When we went to lunch afterwards?
Yeah.
And it was like, how many? 35?
Right. Yeah, party of 35.
Now, if you
please.
Remember, it was a lot of y'all. I went and got me a drink.
Mm-hmm. I don't remember that.
I went and got a drink because I remember when I came back, I said, what you got there? I said, Jack and Coke, uh-huh. Jack and Ginger Ale. Uh-huh. He said, ooh, maybe I should get one. I was like, yeah. I said, I'm going to need this right now. That's a lot of people. I don't know who, what,
right,
I don't know
right.
what's going on.
Yep.
And then it was Christmas. And then that was like times 1,000.
Yeah.
I was like, Tyra, don't go far. I don't know mm-hmm. anybody.
Yep.
And I said, I said previously on the show, I think the next year, Christmas, Uncle Bobby said to tell my son I need something. Mm-hmm. I had no idea who his son was. No clue. I just came in and said, yeah, Uncle Bobby needs something, y'all.
Yep.
I had no idea what was going on. But
yeah, that's
but having that experience, that family experience, that helps. Now, I can't speak to what previous,
mm-hmm.
but you know, that can intimidate people.
Oh, absolutely.
That can be a very intimidating.
It can.
You know,
I think I said this too in one of our previous episodes. It was intimidating for me because I have two first cousins mm-hmm. and I would see them once every decade, like legitimately. Mm-hmm. I think they moved out of Philadelphia in like 84 and I didn't see them again until 99 maybe.
Wow.
So my family is small. You know what I mean? So when I first went around our family now, but y'all family, I was like, this is ridiculous. I don't even...
And you know what's crazy? What
the hell is happening here?
The one side of my family that where we don't get... I have many first cousins mm-hmm. on that side.
Mm-hmm.
Many first cousins. On the other side, I'm the only cousin. Mm. Like, I'm the only one. Like, I have cousins, but they're, like, second.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Okay.
But, like, I have, on my side, my uncle that had, like, 7, 8, 10 kids.
Oh, wow.
You know what I mean? And, yeah. Like, all of them had many kids. I think I think my father was the only one that just had one.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody had kids. So, it's an experience because you have little bit to a lot to grand total of a million.
But I will say this, like, I knew because my family was so small, like, I'm grateful that we have this family, like, that I married into this because I know that my only child, like, when I'm gone, he's always going to have somebody. Right. You know what I mean? Right. Like, because, like, my grandmother's gone. Like, when my mom leaves, that's pretty much it. You know what I mean? Like, it's me. So I'm grateful that Eli does have as much family as he has through Goose. So
it was just like when we first started the 10-7 group, I was so excited. I was like, babe, we got like over 200 followers. He was like, is that all your cousins?
Yeah. No, it's like a third of them.
But the crazy thing is, was it was like the same day that I had invited like 400 people to
the group. Right. He's talking about, that's all your cousins.
Mm-hmm. Hey, but sometimes you got to ask because it could have been.
It could have. It very well could have.
Definitely could have been.
All right. Let's get back to this. Okay, so we're still in the dating category. This one I thought was interesting. Shoot, I lost it. Hang on.
Uh-oh.
Oh, here it is. What would cause you? You know what, Goose, you never answered the last question, but that's all right.
About what?
I done lost the question now. So we're gonna start with you. Yeah, I saw that wink. I saw that wink. He think he being slick.
He's busy. He's recording.
Whatever.
I'm live right now.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What will cause you to end a relationship? Would you be able to forgive and forget and renew the relationship? This is just dating, though. I don't know.
Which one is that?
It's close to the bottom. It's under the dating category.
It all depends on the situation.
See, dating, if you're talking about dating, what would cause you to end
it? It could be anything.
It could be a very...
Pots in the refrigerator.
Exactly.
Like, I can't take this anymore.
Pots in the refrigerator?
Yes.
Goose and I just had a little side conversation in the kitchen.
About pots in the refrigerator?
I hate having pots in the refrigerator.
Who puts pots in the refrigerator?
Me. Sometimes.
I actually have pots that... Are made to go
in the refrigerator.
They have lids to them, like little plastic lids. That, like,
now I'm talking about you cook it, and instead of putting it away in the container, you put that joint in.
Right. I know what you're saying, but I've done it. The pots, I've had a set of pots that
But she's saying that, is that she doesn't have those pots.
Oh, you got rid of them?
Oh, damn it. Christmas is in 3 days. How much time do you have today to go get them pots?
I told you, the temptation.
Like, the temptation.
When I was in my dating era, if I was at a girl, I was over the fridge. She got a pot in the refrigerator.
Oh, this ain't gonna work.
Like, this ain't gonna work.
This is a deal breaker.
As he slams the refrigerator.
This ain't gonna work at all.
Deal breaker.
Offense to you sisters and brothers. I'm sure some of y'all out there too. Mm-hmm. That put pots in the refrigerator. That's just not my thing.
especially since you can get Rubbermaid containers. I should have got you Rubbermaid containers for
Christmas. We have plenty. I have a set of Lock and Lock.
Oh, I love the Lock and
but
Lock.
But I need some Temptations, you know, wink, wink, maybe next year.
Mm-hmm. A what?
The Temptations.
The not the singers.
Yeah. They go Rolling
from
Stone.
They go from the stove.
Listen to Rolling Stone. You know what, Goose, get out.
They go from the stove to the fridge. So you can cook in them, and then they can go in the fridge.
Wait, what?
It's a ceramic dish with a plastic cover.
Find the link on the queue and send it to him.
It's the brand name.
Temptation. Not the five Temptations one, Mike. Not them.
Remind me around Christmas time next year.
Remind him in like August.
I won't even be in the store.
Christmas in July.
When I was in a relationship.
QVC.
My deal breaker was always small lies. Like little white lies.
Like I fell asleep and I didn't hear the phone ring?
Right. Mm-hmm. Like, if you're going to tell...
How you know that? How you know that's a lie, though?
That's an example. What I'm saying is little white lies. Like, if you tell little white, like, you lie about your age, you lie about where you live, you lie about... That's your mama car.
You lie about where you live? How old are these people?
People lie about dumb stuff. And my thing is, once I find out you lie about something little, mm-hmm. My trust is gone. Because if you're going to lie about the little thing, mm-hmm. definitely going to lie about the big thing. Mm-hmm. And I can't trust you. So little lies, I was out the door. Out. ghost you real quick.
What if it's like a white lie? Like
my cutoff is tremendous.
What if he doesn't feel like going somewhere?
What if it was like a little white lie? Like, nah, I ain't fart.
That's harmless. A little pop off. That's harmless.
I don't know, but that would get my.
I might lie about that now.
And my spider senses would be
actually, I
no,
lie.
You won't.
I'll let you know.
Because he'll be like, oh, excuse me, babe.
Fart game, your turn.
Excuse me,
if it's only two of you in the room, like, the shit going to be obvious.
Right. No, but if it's two of us in the room, I will be like, was that you?
He does. And I'm like, you know good and well.
Yeah. Ooh, Tyra, but this is good. When you get down to your part, to my part. Saw this one.
Which one? Uh-oh. So that was my deal breaker in a relationship. Yeah. That was my deal breaker in a relationship. Little white lies. What about you, J. Chris?
What? Now I'm looking like I don't even remember what we were talking about.
What would cause you to end a relationship? What's a deal breaker in a relationship?
I mean, when you're dating.
When you're dating, I mean, I guess, you know, there's a lot, like you said, there's a lot of things that cause you to end a relationship when you're dating because you don't have to stick around.
And also, what is the definition of dating? Because when I was dating, like I went out with females and with ladies and they mispronounce certain words.
Oh, my God.
Gucci. I don't like that either.
I can't do that.
But it depends.
You show a drop of dumbness and I'm out. Are you serious?
I can't deal with stupid people.
Well, no, I don't want to deal with stupid. But Goose's stuff would be so bad. Goose, everything was a deal breaker for him. Like, he'd be like, you know, she said something stupid. And I'd be like, well, what's stupid? He'd be like, no, just the way she was thinking was dumb.
Like, if you say Pacific.
A Pascal.
You mean to say specific?
All right, so we can go down the whole line.
Wait, but with that, I do want to say that at some point in time, I did realize that I'm not perfect either.
Perfect.
That's the 1800.
That was my Mike Tyson.
That's the 1800.
I'm not perfect either. Mm-hmm. So I started to change my thinking.
Yeah, me too.
And now I'm married.
Wait, you know what? And I would like to ask this question, please. Because you started changing your thinking. Is this something that I did? Like, she's a bit of a bonehead. But I really enjoy being with her. Is that what happened? Please tell me that's not what happened.
Not at all.
Because I'm often wondering that. Because like,
I'm going to get one of these cookies.
For years, he will always be like, no, she said something stupid. And there are plenty of times that I say something and I'll be like, oh my God, that was really stupid. And he sticks around. So I'm like, is it? What happened?
Get Down Syndrome comment.
Right, That was pretty bad. Sometimes I do say something.
Broke out the whole tin of grandma cookies.
Oh, I put that out there.
All right, for the one person that's been riding with us, Mara, on the live, my arm's getting tired. So... Everybody,
Tamara, right?
Yeah.
Tamara.
Everybody,
Tamara.
Say hi to Tamara.
Hi, Tamara.
So, I'm about to hang up, Tamara.
So there's many things that can
check
cause
the rest of the show out. All right, 7 o'clock every day.
There's many things that can cause you to end a relationship, right? There was another part to that question. There was another part to that statement. There was what caused you to end a relationship? Oh, and what would make you bring it back?
Mm-hmm.
There's many things for that too, because you could be like, well, I ended this for something stupid.
Mm-hmm.
You could say I was wrong,
right?
And let's give it.
Would you be able to forgive?
There's some people that would say I'm not going backwards,
because
they'll say going backwards was, you know, if we had a chance, but we're, you know, it is what it is. For me, it would be if I know I was wrong, or if I thought the relationship was worth giving another shot. Like I've been in plenty of relationships where I thought giving it another shot, not necessarily meaning I had the opportunity, but I've been in plenty of relationships where I said, maybe another shot. Sometimes you'll be wrong, sometimes you break. I've given another shot, and sometimes you're reminded why you broke up in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, it's various things. Right. Like it's various things for both of those. Right. Why you break up? Why you get back together? Various. So. I picked my feet up off the floor. I said what I got to say. I let one of y'all do it. Y'all right over there, Goose.
Yep.
All right. So we did two topics for our.
Anybody else going to answer?
Oh, Goose, did you go?
What's the question?
Oh my God. What's the question? So, if you're dating, what would cause you to end a relationship?
Oh, he answered.
Oh
that
yeah.
Part.
Oh yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
He answered that part.
Oh yeah. We, right. I did
but,
that.
But what would cause you to
bring it back?
To bring it back to try to.
I don't know, I guess,
reconcile.
You know, maybe it's the self-reflection. Mm-hmm. I mean, because if I want to speak honestly, some of the stuff that I, you know, stopped dealing with people for at the time was probably petty. But I was 20 something. Okay. You know what I mean? You live and you learn. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So maybe if I would have, you know, did that whole self-reflection piece earlier, maybe I would have had an opportunity to, you know, rerun some of those old relationships. But hey, I'm married now.
Like not being able to get past the fact that somebody got dolphin teeth.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, well, you know what? I've actually.
Yeah.
When I was younger, I can remember doing something like ending a relationship. So stupid. Because the girl with breath stink. Wait a minute, hold up.
Here's why it was stupid.
Because she just, and I knew this happened, she just ate a bag of sour cream and onion chips.
That was stupid.
Could have been like,
so her breath ain't, yo, her breath didn't stink. It just was stinking at the time.
I was like, man, what the?
Like, yo, I can't mess with you no more.
Yo, I can't like I didn't say yo. That. Why did I didn't you say like
you have some gum?
Yeah, I didn't say like, look, your breath stink, we can't do this. I didn't put it like that, but in my mind it was like her breath stink.
So
we can't
she's
do
like
this.
These sour cream and onion chips ruined my relationship.
I ain't gonna never eat sour cream and onion chips again. So I can't honestly to go to the what would bring me back, and it's probably just my own personal character flaw, I guess. Mm-hmm. I don't tend to bring back. Like I have
you don't
a
go backwards.
No.
No. Okay. I don't go backwards. Like if I break up with you or I stop dating you, it's for a good reason. Like I said, my cutoff game is real strong.
But you have never broke up with somebody, you've never broken up with somebody and said, you know, that was kind of that
petty.
Was yeah, that was kind of
no.
petty.
No.
So you was always you lying.
I'm not lying.
I'm not lying, but you like, no.
I've taken somebody back one time, and I honestly wish I've never done it. I should have kept my cutoff the way it is.
So you had no petty in you, huh? I got plenty. I
know. Admitting it.
No, I'm serious. Like, if I break up with you, by the time I break up with you, it's for a good reason, and I don't want you back. But I'm telling my, and it's probably, I don't know where this character flaw in me has come from, but, and maybe not even a character flaw. It could be a gift and a curse, but I'm telling you, I will cut you clean off. Mm. No qualms. And see you in the street and act like we never met. Mm. Like, hey, how you doing? Mm. But I don't take you back. Like, if I broke up with you, I broke up with you for a good reason. And it's no coming back.
I'm trying to think of some of the breakups. Like, sometimes you just, like, a lot of my breakups was just, like, not breakups. They were just kind of, like.
All right, Dan. Well, this just separate. Fizzled. It just fizzled.
Yeah, it just fizzled.
That's how
yeah.
most of mine were. Like, yeah, it was never like, really a break. It
you
was,
went
it
from
fizzled.
Hanging out all the time to not hanging out that much.
Exactly.
To calling every couple of days.
Right. Yeah. Just kind of. Like
talking to once a week,
yeah,
and then once a
fizzled.
Month, and then
and
it's
one
like,
day you're thinking like, "What the hell happened?"
Nah,
no, she's cool people, but I'm yeah, all right, I'm
yeah,
good.
I moved on.
I cuts it.
Yeah, I know. I've never had to do that.
I cuts it. Mm-hmm. All right, so let's go on
no,
to
you
the.
You cut dudes when you met me.
I did.
I was the showstopper.
But it wasn't anything serious. It wasn't anything serious with those cats. So, but yeah, I did. I did get rid of them.
Yeah, you was breaking up with dudes after the camping trip.
Oh, and the one guy did propose. I forgot about
yeah,
him.
How the hell did I go in for a whole cookie and came out with this? This is what I came out with.
The one dude proposed, and then she took the engagement ring and got me some studs made.
Oh,
you lying.
You about to get shot.
You know what?
You lying. For real?
For real.
It happened. I don't even remember. I think that was probably your idea.
Yeah, it probably was, because that's the type shit I think about.
All right, Zyra, what you leading towards?
All right, so I'm leading towards, there's a few things on these deep conversations.
This is the married couples,
for married
right?
couples. I think this is a good one. It gets you to kind of, you know, reflect and think about yourself.
Speaking to the mic.
Sorry. So it's the first one. It says, is there something that you would like to change about yourself? How can you achieve that change?
Change about myself?
Yeah.
What does that have to do with marriage?
It could be something about you that maybe has a negative impact on your marriage that you know that you do or something. And do you recognize that? And are you willing to change it or not?
I'll go.
Okay, yeah, I need some
time. Because some of this I'm going to have to think of while I'm saying.
Okay.
If I wouldn't change anything about me, but let's say if I wanted, you all right over there?
I had to burp.
Okay, just making sure.
I was trying not to do it in the mic.
All right, good job. All right, so I wouldn't change anything. Like, I love me some me. But two things I would do, I would change being petty. I kind of like being petty. I ain't going to hold you. But anyway, I would change
petty.
But
that's like your personality, though. The petty is your personality.
Yeah, the petty is like get back.
You know but that's not a good thing, though, all the time.
For you.
As long as it's not vicious, I don't think there's anything wrong with it. But I'm also not in your marriage, so go ahead.
Well, I'm not petty. Well,
no, he's not petty towards
me. I'm not petty towards her, but I have. There is some pettiness. But I wouldn't be, I guess I would call it stubborn. Mm-hmm. Would you say stubborn? Am I stubborn?
With some things, yes.
Yeah, because like, let's say I'm wrong about something, which is like extremely rare, right? Mm-hmm. Extremely rare I'm wrong about anything. you got right over there, you got belch again. and I know I'm wrong. Mm-hmm. Like at first I was defending myself, then I realized I'm wrong. But I'll still try to defend myself. But I think a lot of people do that.
So
I
you
do.
Deny to you
I
die,
totally
huh?
do it. I totally do it.
Hey, keep the lie alive. Mm-hmm.
This lie is so strong and I'm holding on to it. I believe this bullshit.
Exactly. Okay.
Goose.
So what's the question?
Oh, my God.
Is there something
doing? Call one question.
What were you doing?
Is there something that you would like to change about yourself? How can you achieve that change? And these are deep conversations for married couples now.
Keep the lie alive. That's one of my favorite parts of that Martin show.
What would I change about myself?
And how can you achieve it?
Yes, you, Goose. What would you change about you?
I would probably want to be less analytical.
Oh, yeah, that would be great.
See the life I live.
Is that bad that I said that? I'm agreeing with you.
Because sometimes things get in my head.
I get it.
I wish y'all could see what he's doing.
And it just runs.
Yeah.
Like what? Please give an example.
And I have to pull myself back in.
I'm like that.
I do that too.
An example,
I'm like, yo, I'm tripping.
Like I'll start an argument in my head with somebody. And be arguing like a mug in my head. And then now I got attitude.
Are you serious? Wait, you do that, Goose? Yeah.
And then you be like,
I don't even like
this.
You.
Ain't even real.
And the tire be like, what you got an attitude
if you
for?
Do
like,
that?
And then I'm
relax. Why are you hollering? Am
I hollering? Yes. I holler? I'm sorry.
Tire be like, you got an attitude. I'm like, no, I don't. Yes, you do. And I can't explain, like, I was arguing with you in my head.
Yeah, because that sounds psychotic.
Yeah, exactly.
Because you know why? Because
you you plan things, and then.
But so y'all not in an argument, but you just plan it. Argument in your head.
So let's put it like this. I'm gonna take something like really stupid, right? Mm-hmm. Let's say I'm trying to grab that bowl. Nobody on air can see this bowl. Mm-hmm. Let's say I try to grab that bowl, and let's say the bowl slips and I break some ornaments, or let's say. I'm imagining that I try to grab the bowl and some ornaments break. And then Tyree, in my head, asks me, why were you trying to take the... And in my head, now I'm like back and forth.
You're preparing for the...
But then I've allowed it like, to tap into my psyche in a bit.
In the fester.
Right.
And then I come downstairs not knowing what the heck happened.
So I'm like, hey, man, can I have some juice? I'm like, man...
And he got a whole attitude.
You like
over an argument that never happened.
What you need juice for?
Yeah, that needs to be fixed.
No, you go in there and be thirsty.
Like it's just like, you know, just something like that. Like, I'll do that. I've always done stuff like that.
Really?
Yeah.
Cause you kinda,
I mean, cause sometimes I'll be thinking and sometimes I'll be thinking of stuff and it don't even have nothing to do with you or
right.
nothing.
Right.
But it just got me in the funk. So I catch myself. I be like, oh, no, I'm bugging. I reel myself back in.
Right, exactly. Now, with that being said,
right,
as guys,
I ain't crazy.
As guys,
sure you are.
As guys, now we've talked about this on previous shows. We probably do that to have the best argument.
Yeah.
To have the best statements.
So you
statements,
can win.
To have the best statements.
That competitiveness.
Women probably don't do that. See, y'all probably do and don't say it, but women probably don't do that because y'all always have the good points in the argument already and we think about it later on.
Yeah. But you know what? I don't think that is the ladies have the good points in arguments. I think they don't give a shit, which allows them to have good points in argument. Because in arguments, we can say, we can hit below the belt, but we be like, no.
I'm not going to say that. She might cry.
Yeah.
They don't care.
She don't do that. Right. We don't, we're not going to do that.
We're not
going to do that.
They
that
will.
Is not true.
That
I,
is definitely
that's not true.
True.
I do.
We only got 2 years in, though. So it could be true later.
We've had some arguments, though.
Mm-hmm. It could be true. We had a handful.
It'll probably be true later because I've said some stuff. And after it comes out of my mouth, I'll be like, oh, I probably shouldn't have said that. That's going to hurt.
Me too. Yeah. I've said some things and I'll be like, nah, I shouldn't have said that. I'm stupid. But I can't apologize yet.
Right.
Because she ain't going to believe
me. Because you're being petty.
And you ain't going to believe me if I apologize too soon.
Plus, I needed to defend. Like, there's a whole plan around some of this stuff. Right? Like,
okay. You orchestrate your argument.
Oh, he does.
We had this discussion before.
He does.
And sometimes I play it all out in my head. I'm like, I'm going to say this. And she's going to respond with either this
exactly.
or that.
Exactly.
And then I will rebut with this. I play the whole joint out.
Oh like
one time, Tyra and I was having a
who are these men that
to
we
the
married?
Point where sometimes I'd be like, "Babe, we had an argument. Don't worry about it. I fixed everything. It's all good."
You know, you can do that then.
Yeah.
One time,
you come home with gifts. Like, "Babe, we had an argument. And I fixed everything. And here I bought you diamonds."
Yeah. One time, Tyra and I had a heated discussion, mm-hmm. and I don't even remember what it was about. And I probably. We were both wrong.
Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. I was, know about the situation.
Look, she's like, hold on. Before you say I'm wrong.
I was wrong.
Before you say I'm wrong.
We were probably both wrong. I might have been a little more wrong.
You were more wrong.
You don't even know what I'm talking about.
Whatever
all right,
it is.
See y'all at 45, 55.
But in my mind, knowing I'm a little more wrong, see, I shouldn't even say this because now I'm going to mess it up for the rest of my life.
Absolutely.
Me knowing I was a little more wrong, I tried to flip it.
Oh, so I'm right. You do be trying to flip stuff.
No.
Yes,
not like you're thinking. Not like you're thinking.
Yes, you did.
It's not that I was trying to flip it, but I wasn't trying to flip it as if you did something wrong. I had to take something else from the argument and apply that.
So he diverted.
Exactly.
He's a flipper, a diverter,
right,
or whatever you exactly. want to call it. But
so,
I catches
look,
him all the time.
Look,
no, you don't.
So,
yes, I do.
So suppose you was arguing about something burning in the oven.
Mm-hmm.
He would be like, well, the window in the oven need to be cleaned. I couldn't even see inside. Who's supposed to do that? So he diverted from one argument to an argument that he think he can win
no,
better.
She does that.
I don't do that.
She does that. Yes,
I do not
she
do that.
She does that. I got to take it to a whole different jump.
Oh.
My bad.
I got to take it to a whole different jump. Like
we are?
Once we were talking about something. We were discussing something, heated debate. And I hate being cut off when I'm talking. I hate it. Like it just gets under my skin and she kept cutting me off. So then it turned into that. For me.
Oh,
for me,
yeah.
It turned
yeah.
into that.
She be like, why you keep cutting me off?
Like, I can't even get a word in. Because now it's not about.
So now that is something that she's definitely done.
Oh, yeah.
And she knows that she's done it.
Yeah, she knows.
So now she can't even deny it. But because she already heated, she not going to let it die.
Right. She actually did the other night. But she apologized. We weren't arguing. I was just trying to talk about one of the Facebook comments. Mm-hmm. And
do you
she
feel like you're being attacked right now?
No, I don't feel like I'm being attacked.
She's taking notes.
I see you after the show.
It's all right. It's all right. She's taking notes.
I'm waiting for you at the door.
She's taking notes. But what she doesn't realize is mentally, I'm taking notes too.
See? Because that's he petty.
Exactly.
I'm not petty.
Because guarantee, he already know what you going to say.
Absolutely, because I've already had this discussion in my head.
Yep. It's happening right now.
He's totally orchestrated your entire...
You see this?
Your entire argument.
I'm careful with my responses, so I know how you should probably respond.
You know how I should probably.
But if you don't, I'm also
prepared. I'm going to catch you off guard one
day. Watch. I'm sure you are. I'm sure you are. And then that's going to go into the database.
What was the second part of that question? Do you remember?
How do you achieve this change you want to make about yourself?
Oh, I forgot what the hell we was talking about.
Not being so petty.
No, that's not what it said.
And right, what about you, Tara? Because you didn't answer the question.
I don't remember the question.
Is there something
that about this couple
you,
right here?
Right. I don't remember the question.
Y'all just don't.
We're the older couple.
We're old. I'm not that damn old, man.
We tearing these grandma cookies up, bro.
I know. Is there something that you would like to change about yourself?
Take
How
my phone and
can
pan.
You achieve that change? Is there something about yourself that you'd like to change?
Yes, I am selfish, and I freely admit it. And I can be petty, very petty, and in the middle of an argument, like I said, I'll say something really mean and hateful. And then the second it comes out, I'm like, probably should have said that. You know what I mean? Like, what can I do to change it? Is that the second part?
Yeah.
How can yep. That's the second part. What can you do to change it?
Not do it.
He was like, I'm listening.
I don't think
he's taking notes.
I don't think I'm as selfish as I used to be. Do you?
No.
Like, there was a time when, like, Goose would be like, can I have a sip? And I'd be like, no, it's mine. I don't even know. Why are you even looking at my cup? You know what I mean? Like, that's really selfish.
You ask.
Hmm? You better ask.
I don't ask Tyra. I just wait till she turns around.
I have a thing about people's mouths being on anything that belongs to me. Like, even my own kid, like...
She had, like, I'm Swamp Thing.
That was my stuff. Swamp Thing.
Yeah, Tyra don't want me drinking her stuff either. That's why I wait till she turns around. And I'll drink the whole jar.
Yes.
But like,
and walk away.
Like, Eli will drink... when he was smaller, anyway, if he would drink off of something that was mine, I'd be like, that's yours now.
I'm probably the same.
That's a good way to get a drink, though.
It is. I'm probably saying, I don't like people drinking on my stuff.
So I'm not as selfish as I used to be. Petty, I'm probably going to stay with petty. I'm probably going to keep that. That's, I can't change
that.
Yeah,
that's where you live, baby.
I do. I live there. I do.
Yeah.
I can't.
Kanye
shrugs. Yeah, I don't really.
Your character.
I really.
Kanye shrugs.
I don't want to say I don't care. But I don't care.
But you don't care.
I don't care.
You don't.
You
should probably learn to be more tolerant, too. Yeah.
I think my tolerance has gotten better.
No.
No? Well, then I'm probably going to die this way.
Nah. We 46 minutes in there?
I don't know. So let me go to the next question.
How many more we got?
We're only doing two from each category.
I still wanted to talk about the the 50s housewife thing.
All right, we can talk about that.
Or we can do that next time.
No, yeah. We could. We could totally do that next time.
Or we could do that on the morning show we got coming up next year.
Yeah.
We could say that for
morning
our morning show.
No.
Does that mean we need to get up earlier in the morning?
No.
Okay.
Well, yes.
What?
Tyra was like, can we have an afternoon show? Can we have a tea time show?
I'm surprised Tyra agreed to this 10 o'clock, 10:30.
Okay, so let me do this last question.
Y'all know. I got rest.
I am too.
All right. This is whatever. This is our last question, and this is deep conversation for married couples. Do you and your spouse have the same opinion about if the glass is half empty or half full? What changes can you make your life? What changes can you make to make your life more fulfilling? So do you both see life as the glass half empty or the glass half full?
I'm a half full dude.
I'm a complete pessimist.
Yep.
So I'm half empty?
Yep. She's
you
half full. I'm the yin to her yang.
Yes, absolutely. Indeed.
I'm a half full.
I share my blessings with her because she has none.
Are you serious? Shut up.
She has no blessings. I'm a half full guy.
You think you're a half full?
Absolutely.
Uh-oh.
Absolutely a half full guy.
Burly.
I've always been a half full guy.
Erica Tate says half full.
All right.
I've always been a half full guy.
Mine's is half empty and there's a hole in the bottom of the cup.
Oh, now that's terrible.
I know. I don't know what
my
mother did to me. Right? I am like the most spoiled, rotten, first world child. You know what I mean? Like, I don't get it. I don't understand why I am so.
I think I am.
Tell them why you mad, son.
I don't know.
I think I'm half full.
Sometimes.
I'm
Lenny said pour it into a smaller glass. Thanks, Lynn.
Yeah, I think I'm in between. Some things I'm half full, some things I'm half empty.
Oh, it depends on what it is.
Yeah.
I'm a half full dude. You know why? Because I command my own destiny.
That's how I feel about it.
You dig what I'm saying? So if you're a half empty person,
you don't command your own destiny.
And what is that? That tells me how you feel about yourself.
No, I love myself.
I see. Sometimes I see Tyra as a half empty person because. Because on a lot of things, Tyra's sky starts to fall. She's like, "Oh my God! Oh, how we gonna do this? What the hell is that noise? Oh. Banging on the door. Hold
it's
on,
the police.
Hold on. My bad. Do I gotta run out the back door?
Yes.
So yeah, I had to go handle that business at the door real quick. So I think what I was saying was sometimes
you think Tyra, I have empty.
Sometimes I think you have empty because sometimes I feel like your sky is falling with like things that aren't that big of a deal.
Well, nothing is a big deal to you.
No, it's not.
The house could be on fire.
And you know what?
As long as everybody that I love is outside,
Goose is like, we have insurance. Get the hell out of the house. Let it burn. Yeah, that's how he is.
Nothing is serious to you. Nothing.
I wouldn't say nothing, but, you know.
Or at least you don't act like it is.
I don't let things. I've learned that you can't allow things to determine how you're going to live. You got to live the way you're going to live your life. I don't let things, like if I'm in traffic, I hate traffic, right? You know, I hate traffic. But if I get cut off in traffic, I'm not going to go crazy. I might get mad, but I'm not going to go crazy. Whereas Tyra is going to go nuts.
Oh, yeah.
She's going to go berserk.
Tyra chased this person down. I was like, yo, if you don't slow the hell down.
I have chased somebody before.
See? There you go. That's what I'm saying. So, I mean, my sky is never falling. I try to never allow my sky to fall.
Wasn't that a book or a cartoon, The Sky is Falling?
That was a James Bond thing, too. Skyfall.
Oh,
James. No, but I was thinking a cartoon. It's probably
Chicken Little, Sky is Falling.
Yeah, but see, but the other thing about it is that, so I know if I show panic, other people are going to show panic.
Especially me, because you're the most cool-headed person ever.
So, even if I want to, oh my God, this shit is.
Keep your cool.
I can't, because I know whatever I show, she going to show 1,000-fold.
Right.
Oh, maybe that's
true. If I go nuts, she's definitely
going to. She be like, yo, if he's scared, oh my God, we going to die.
Right.
That is true, though. Like, if he panics, he never panics. If he panics, that's it. It's Annie, get your gun.
Lenny said, I'm tolerant to the big things in life, but let me trip over a rug, and I'm cussing the rug. I'm ready to throw it out. I know that's right, man.
Right. Let the Eagles lose.
He said, let the Eagles cussing and fussing
and hitting the wall. I'm like, for real, babe? It's a football game.
I ain't never hit the wall.
I've heard you hit something before. You slam a door.
No.
Oh, shit.
No. Maybe I dropped something.
Did you lose some money? You must have bet on that game and lost some money.
Oh, Lord.
Tamara said, she's talking about one game.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Was it the Super Bowl?
No, it wasn't the Super Bowl. She's talking about one game.
He was hot as fish grease.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Mm-hmm. She was talking about one game. Last year, the game against Dallas, we lost in overtime. Mm-hmm. And that game was kind of like this year's game where it was determined.
They thought
it was going to determine us making the playoffs or not, which it in turn did not. But when we lost to Dallas last year in that overtime game, the season was pretty. We thought the season was over, and that's why I was. The Eagles have lost many times this year. Have I been as mad this year?
I've seen that time. Even if the Sixers lose, you'd be PO'd.
Yeah, because the Sixers are frustrating.
Why are they frustrated? Because they're supposed to be really good and they're getting a dime of that money.
Why are you frustrated?
Wait a minute. Let me finish now. The Sixers are supposed to be good, and they're supposed to be at a certain level, and they do frustrating things during the game that they do not overcome. But my anger at the Sixers will My anger at the Sixers will not last as long as my anger with the Eagles, because the Eagles only play once a week. The Sixers might have a game tomorrow or 2 days from now. So, you know, I can get over it quick. Like last night. Sixers lost last night. Sixers
play like four times as many games.
Right.
As
Sixers lost last night.
Who cares?
And what I say? I said the Sixers made me mad.
I mean, that's about all you heard from it. I watched them lose. No, you.
Tyra, you be tripping. Take it in pan.
he trips, y'all.
No, see?
He
no.
trips. All right, it's time for Would You Rather.
Would You Rather?
We ran into Tobias Harris at the Four Seasons. The other week.
Who did we run into?
Tobias Harris. Remember we did the Four Seasons?
Oh, yeah. I was like, oh, did I go to high school with him?
Right.
I did recognize, right, so what's his face? Fletcher
said,
Cox?
You must have been pissed off for the last three games then.
Who said that?
Yes.
Lenny.
Oh.
Yes.
Yes, Justin was pissed off.
Well, Donovan McNabb, Fletcher Cox.
Not the same person, though, bitch. Oh. Stop. Just stop.
Yes, Lenny. Justin was pissed off for the last game. All right, so it's time for Would You Rather.
What last game? Sixers game?
Whatever game.
Eagles game.
Are the Eagles playing tomorrow? Is the season over for them?
At the time of this recording, the Eagles will be playing the Cowboys tomorrow.
Oh, okay. Right. Oh, the Cowboys, and we don't like each other, right?
No.
Yes, where's, that's right. I got to call Mike Bryant.
I got mine. You can look for yours.
I got mine. All right, who's going to pin? All right, y'all, we're getting ready for Would You Rather.
Right, you can say goodbye to the Facebook Live if you want to do that.
I was going to say, I wanted to see if they wanted to put some Would You Rathers up.
Oh, okay. All right.
So, we're going to, I'm trying to do this. We're going to do Would You Rather at this point. So if you have a Would You Rather, you can go ahead and
I know Tamara.
And
come on
we'll read it.
Come on, Tamara.
We're almost at an hour.
Come on, Tamara. I'm going to do mine first. Here, somebody pan, please. Thanks. All right, so here's my Would You Rather. I thought this was pretty interesting. Would you rather be able to detect any lie you hear or get away with any lie you tell?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's...
Get away with any lie I tell.
Absolutely. Any lie I tell. Absolutely.
Yeah. Get away with any lie I tell.
Get away with any lie.
I would rather to detect any lie I hear.
No.
Nope.
But see, that's the thing. Are you prepared to hear hear the what you might hear about yourself?
Yeah, but not only
that. That's true, but I'd rather detect a lie.
We are currently living with not knowing what the lie is.
We know what the lie is.
And we're okay.
But we assume what the lie is, but we're okay with it.
They've been
lying
to us all our lives.
We live.
We have no choice.
Exactly. We live, we move on.
They lied about
Why change any of that?
Right.
But if you tell a lie, it is that person's discretion as to whether they choose to believe it or not.
Right.
And if they don't believe your lie, then they name you a liar.
Exactly.
So.
Wait, Lenny said. Okay.
Because of that, I would rather be able to get away with any lie I tell.
I would rather be able to
get away. I'd rather detect any lie I hear.
Lenny says he'll detect, then you can't get away with it.
Who's Lenny?
Lenny
is our good friend Lenny. He's in our group.
What's up, Lenny?
Yeah.
He's in our group. Everyone says, hey, Lenny.
Lenny has military background, so he might be like...
He might be...
Hi, Lenny.
Robert De Niro and the Falkers.
We got to hustle
Yeah, he does
up.
Have a military background.
All right, we got to hustle
so
it
we're
up.
We're going to wrap it up. We're going to say goodbye to... Facebook Live. Say bye-bye.
I got to say bye to my Instagram Live, too.
Okay. Bye, Instagram.
Bye, Instagram.
Okay, I just,
bye, Facebook.
My joint just ended.
Deuces.
Catch the show, y'all. Monday
Hold up. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
No. We're
we not
just
finishing
going
the live.
Show.
No,
we're just going to
live. We're just getting rid of the live.
Yeah.
Lenny says hello, guys.
All right.
Because you can only go live for like an hour on Instagram and stuff.
Okay.
On the gram.
Oh, because you've been live the whole time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Live the whole show. Yeah, actually, I would want to get away with any lie I tell. Absolutely.
Yeah. Yep. See, I find that weird. Like, if you want to get away with any lie you tell, like, do you lie a lot?
Here's the thing.
That means you must lie all the time.
But do you not lie at all?
Exactly.
I do. I'm like, I ain't going to work today. Oh, my stomach hurts. I won't be in.
See, but dig this. Like I said before, you're right now living
with every lie.
With not knowing what lie is a lie.
Mm-hmm.
So that wouldn't change you for the negative.
Right.
Knowing the lies would only change you for the positive. I mean, you dig what I'm saying? Mm-hmm.
Think about the movie Liar Liar and how many people's feelings he was hurting when they were talking to him.
Right. So now if every time you hear a lie, if you knew it was a lie, you'd be like, that mother, everybody would be.
Mm-hmm. How many traffic tickets would you be able to get away with?
If I could get away with a lie?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All of them.
Probably. Come
on. Even those work lies that you just don't even feel like dealing with, but you know you can deal with it, but you just don't feel like dealing with it right now. Mm-hmm. So you're like, oh, you know, I need to discuss this with my supervisor, and I'll get back to you mm-hmm. as soon as I can. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Lie.
You just want to get that person off the phone. Mm-hmm. Lie.
Mm-hmm. Is that lie?
Or the lie. Or the lie.
When you're calling in somewhere and they're saying, and the operator on the other end tells you the same thing, you could be like, I know you're lying.
Exactly. I know you're lying. Uh-huh. Like, let me speak to your manager.
She's not here. Ma'am, I know you're lying.
I know you're lying.
Where's your manager? So, I don't know. I'm going to stick to my
guns. Tell Betty to pick up the phone.
Right. Uh-huh. I'm going to stick to my guns in this one, and I'd rather.
Stick to your guns.
Okay.
Yep.
All right, let's wrap it up.
All right, let's wrap it up.
Hold on. I thought we were going to do another one.
Oh, we got one.
Oh, okay.
I got one here. All right. So, would you rather have unlimited international first class tickets or never have to pay for food at restaurants?
First class tickets.
Y'all looking at me. I would say that's a tough one because I'm not a foodie, right? I can make a sandwich and be cool. But flying first class, like you're gonna get there the same amount of time as everybody else, mm-hmm. just more comfortable, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. I would rather. I mean, you're gonna save money. You're gonna save more money at restaurants than you do in first class, because you're gonna eat more times than you fly, right?
Exactly.
So, as I'm looking into it, way too deep.
I was gonna say, go ahead with your rationale, because I'll tell you my rationale when you're done.
Yeah, I would rather have, what is it, unlimited international first class?
Yep.
I'll take the unlimited international first class. Mm-hmm.
Good job.
Yep.
I'll take that.
Yep. Yep-er.
Because my rationale is I've taken many flights. I have yet to fly first class.
Me either.
I've eaten at many restaurants. I've eaten at 5-star restaurants and paid.
Mm-hmm.
So, if I could pay to feed myself, but I have not yet flown first class, and maybe it's my ignorance because I didn't fly first class, because I didn't do enough research, but I haven't. So if I could feed myself, but I haven't flown first class, let's go first class because I continue to feed myself.
Mm-hmm. I would want to fly first class on like a long trip, and like on United Arab Emirates, whatever that thing's called, where you get that whole
the
pod.
Pie.
I would want that.
Yeah. Yep.
Absolutely.
Tyra. First class all the way. That's where I'm going.
Tyra. I feel like Tyra's over there like Googling some
Tyra
stuff.
Like, you know how much I eat?
Tyra's a foodie, so that's...
I am.
Think about the food you get on first class.
Yeah. Like, you get like warm nuts and everything. Like,
but I'm
most,
like, I wouldn't
a lot
have to cook
and if it's long,
life, I could just go eat out every day for the rest of my life. I wouldn't have to cook.
You would.
You would get tired of
you
it.
Like, eventually, so? Yep. I would want to home. Like, think about people who, like, maybe are bachelors and all they do is eat out because they don't cook. They're right. Like, I would love a home-cooked meal. Right.
But then, I'm a foodie, but I like to travel, too.
Right.
So, this is hard for me.
Because, I mean, unlimited international travel.
You could go anywhere.
You could be like, yo, let's go to Paris for lunch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Yep.
If I could, on the whim.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Go to another country for lunch.
Anywhere.
I can
fly,
afford
exactly.
the food.
Yeah. Fly to another country and we're going to be on our $40 a day.
Can I trade in my unlimited international first class travel for a private jet?
It didn't say nothing about a private jet.
No, but can I trade it in?
Sure,
I
if don't, you want I to in your head, go ahead.
So
head.
I'll take, you know, y'all going to be surprised as I anyway. Go against, but I'm going to take the travel.
All right, we swear.
Really? You going to take the travel?
I'm going to take the travel.
I was just sure you're going to take the food.
See?
But you wanted to take the food.
I thought about the food, but I was listening to you guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think the travel
I'm telling
is
the travel is the most more economic.
Yeah, the travel's good.
Mm-hmm. I mean, because the thing about it is you
still
have,
I could go to
you
where
still
the
have
food
to work.
Is authentically made.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, you know what? Yeah. Let's go to Italy. I want some real
some
Italian
Some real
food.
Italian food.
Yep. Go have somebody's Nona make us some lunch.
I want some real olive oil.
I mean, but you still have to work, and Chris still got to go to school, so you're going to wind up cooking anyway. That's just how it is. You're not going to. I mean, even though.
Hey, Christian, you go to school. I'm going to California real quick.
I'll be right back.
You know what I mean? So even though, you know what I mean? You can go out to eat every day. It's not going to be practical.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because of schedules and things of that nature. Mm-hmm. You know, and you're going to get tired.
That's
you're going to be like, listen, I done worked all day. I'm going home. Mm-hmm. I'm going to have some hot dogs and French fries.
You know what? But you're going to be tired of taking them flights, too, eventually. Because you're going with that hustle and bustle of the airport.
Yeah. Going through the but security. But you know, first class, get loaded first. Once you get through security and you're in first class, you can afford first class. That means you probably in the Admiral's Bar and the, and all that kind of fly
probably,
stuff.
That's probably, you know what I've I'm never saying? Flown first class, so I don't know. But
you know what I mean? All I know is they got the bigger seats that I walk through before I go to mine.
Yeah, they sure
next
do.
To the bathroom.
And they looking at you as you go by.
Mm-hmm. And what the hell are you looking at? Like, if it wasn't for security, I'd take your seat.
We flew first class back from Mexico.
Oh, word?
Oh, nice.
No, actually, I'm lying. We actually just flew in the front row of the plane, but it was Spirit. So.
At least we could stretch our legs. Shoot. Yeah, that was the worst flight ever.
Oh, yeah. But you know, Spirit just got a, it was on the news, actually. New planes. They get new planes.
Really? Yeah, well, that's good.
Yeah, so the seats are bigger. They still don't recline, but they have like a natural recline. In them, they're supposed to be a little bit better than the previous seats. Yeah,
yeah. Because I just knew, recline. I was like, this my seat must be broke.
That's what I thought. I was so my back was hurting so bad. I was so uncomfortable when I got off of that plane.
But you know what upsets me about flying there? So it used to be doing them the airline a favor if you sat in the emergency exit row.
Mm-hmm.
Now they charge you.
Mm-hmm.
Do they?
To sit in the emergency exit row.
See, I sat in the emergency exit row going to Florida a few years back. But the only thing is, it was like, you got it. Are you able to help?
Yeah. Them used to be the questions.
Right.
You dig what I'm saying? So, because I know when I fly, because I'm a big dude, they be like, yo, would you like to sit in the emergency exit row? Because they want somebody that be able to take the door, because you got to take it off and then throw it out.
Okay.
Now I try to book my seat. I'm like, yo, can I get this? Because the emergency exit row has more leg room.
Right,
And that's how I got down with it. Because the lady was like, I'm going to tell you something. If you can't get it, because it has more leg room. Mm-hmm. I'm like, all right, cool. But now when you try to book the emergency exit row, it's an upcharge.
Mm-hmm.
Guess I'll never be sitting there again.
I was like, I'm doing y'all
a favor.
So,
wait a minute. You want to charge me more and you
and
want
put me to work.
Yeah, if something happens, you want me to go to work.
Put me to work and
charge me more.
Well,
I'll
put it this way. That was American. I don't know if it's every airline.
When I flew.
Are they still around? I don't even know if they're still around.
American?
Yeah,
that's what we flew to Mexico.
Didn't they merge with somebody though and change them?
No.
When I flew to Florida, I sat in the emergency exit, and I sat next to two New York Yankee prospects on the way down. That was pretty cool.
Oh, that's cool.
I don't know if they're still prospects, but that was pretty cool.
That's cool.
Did you have something? Because you got your phone on.
No, I'm good.
Or are you just trolling?
I'm actually doing a little Christmas shopping.
Well, actually, the airing of this show, Christmas will be over. So what did you get?
Can't tell you.
Really? Anybody want to take a peek over?
She closed that real quick.
All right. Well, we're going to close the show right there. We want to thank you for listening to the 10-7 show with
Merry
Tara,
Christmas.
Tyra, Goose, and myself. Merry Christmas. Happy
Merry
New
Christmas.
Year.
Merry Christmas.
I hope your Christmas was enjoyable if you're celebrating, you know. Hope your New Year's is even more enjoyable.
Yes.
I hope
your 2020 is the bomb.
Yes.
Big plans for 2020, y'all. Go. Everybody, make sure you have big plans for 2020.
Yes.
And catch us on the 10-7 Facebook group. We're going to be going live for a little bit on New Year's.
Yep.
So you never know what may happen.
Oh,
tune in.
The foolery.
Keep locked into the group.
All right. Well, there you have it. Make sure you follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at 10-7 Show. Follow New Twist Radio on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at New Twist Radio. And that's about it, man. We want to love y'all for loving us. Happy holidays. Happy New Year. And we'll talk to y'all in 2020. Be out of here.
Yeah.
Peace.
Bye.
I'm a movement by myself, but I'm a force when we're together.
Uh-huh.
Mommy, I'm good all by myself.
I'm good.
But baby, you make me better.
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 Thank you for listening to the 10-7 Show. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at 10-7. Email us at 10-7show@gmail.com. Keep the conversation going in the 10-7 Facebook group. Listen to us daily at 7 p.m. on newtwistradio.com. Download the New Twist Radio app from the Google Play Store.